Hi, my name is Willie Villegas, your host on Salsa La Calle, today's salsa show for the Salsero and You. And today I'm featuring something special. You know that during the Mambo era, which could be categorized from 1940 all the way up to 1960, late 50s, there were three dominating bands that were hitting the Palladium era. And that was the legendary Tito Puente Orchestra, the Tito Rodriguez Orchestra, and today, the gentleman that we're featuring at Salsa en la Calle, Frank Grillo, better known as Machito, and his orchestra. Well, you know, we're featuring Machito because even though those three bands were dominating the Palladium era, the Mambo era, you know, Tito Rodriguez played with Machito's band. Tito Puente played in Machito's band. So, you know, for all sakes that we can just simply say that Machito was probably the first one that was hitting the scene hard. Hitting the Mambo scene very, very hard. Well, today on Salsa en la Calle, we're going to feature the innovator, the man who put together what we call today Afro-Cuban jazz. And you're going to see it live on Salsa en la Calle. Today's salsa show for the Salsero and You. And what we're going to feature first is a tune done by the legendary Machito y su orquesta titled Ahora Sí. First off and foremost, say that what you're watching is probably some rare vintage footage, being that the great legend Machito passed away in the year 1984. Here you're going to see Machito's orchestra performing at City Hall. Yeah, get this, City Hall. Outside, outdoor concert with one of the baddest bands on stage. Let's see if you can recognize a few faces on that stage. Por favor, no se vaya nadie. Thank you.
Lote. Yemaya, Aboyo, Aboyo, Yemaya, Yemaya, Lote, Aboyo, Aboyo, O Junkere, que se mi obo, O Junkere, que se mi obo, mi cara, o cara, o Junkere, mucho allí, mucha salud, pa Celia, pa Tito Puente, pa Pedro, que matanza, silla, pa Guillermo Pelota,
What a jam session, huh? Rey Barreto, Candido. Did you see some of the percussionists that were there? Puente himself. And then, if you looked in the background for a brief second, you saw Incomparable Señor Bobby Capó just standing behind Machito. Well, let me tell you, at that era, in that time, at that concert, which was in the 70s, you know, there was another thing happening, and this was happening in Midtown Manhattan. Park conocido that we know by the name of Central Park. And we're talking about the fountain. In the area around the fountain, there was tremendo rumor at that particular area and that particular era and time. And what you're going to see now is a couple of cats in the middle of Central Park doing something traditional, a little bit out of the norm, since we are in simultaneously talking about the Mambo era and Machito. At this particular time, there was a little thing of bomba and plena in Central Park, and we're going to show you just a little short clip of that so you can check it out.
After World War II, a mass wave of Puerto Ricans migrated to the United States. By the early 1960s, there were some 1.5 million Puerto Ricans living in the New York City area. They became the main supporters and practitioners of modern Latin music, known today as salsa, bringing to it their own musical traditions, the bomba and the plena.
This man graced the planet as much as he did in Japan. Machito's orchestra had the opportunity in 1962, I believe, to go to Japan and feature what we call today Afro-Cuban jazz music. You know, and this gentleman, I mean, when you look at this footage that you're about to see now, you're going to see the legendary Mauricio Smith. You're going to see Leslie Jonikins taking a baritone solo, Chocolate Armenteros on trumpet, and also Doc Cheatham. I mean, this, without a doubt, is vintage footage, it's classic footage, and it's featuring the legendary Machito Orchestra live in Japan. Check this out.
Thank you.
Wasn't that fantastic? The legendary Machito Orchestra live in Japan. For those who are just tuning in now, you are watching Salsa en la Calle, today's Salsa show for the Salsero in You. I'm your host, Willie Villegas, and what we're featuring is the legendary Frank Grillo, Machito. Now, you know, Machito got together with a gentleman by the name of Mario Bauzá, who at the time was already performing with the Cab Calloway Orchestra. He knew himself around town, in Harlem and down in Midtown Manhattan, because in Midtown Manhattan, when the bands were playing in Midtown Manhattan, then you reach fame and notoriety. If you were playing in Harlem, you were just playing in Harlem. That's the way it worked. You had to go downtown to be somebody. Well, Mario Bauzá kept the tradition alive when Machito passed away with the Mario Bauzá Orchestra, featuring some of the most legendary artists that performed with the Machito Orchestra. And now, in part two of this segment, we're going to see the legendary Mario Bauzá con su orquesta pay homage, tribute to the legend, Machito. We'll be right back. You go around the world and you hear La Guarachera del Mundo, Celia Cruz, and then you hear about the legendary woman who passed away and left a legacy of music for us to always cherish, Victoria Yolila Lupe. Now, we're going to feature Machito's sister-in-law, Graciela, another woman with a beautiful and velvet voice coming out of the island of Cuba, and she's going to be doing her classic rendition with the Mario Bauzá Orchestra, a title tune, by the way, which happens to be her favorite, Ay, José. Por favor, no se vaya nadie.
No, no, ay, José, así no es, no. Hazlo otra vez, ven acá, José, hazlo otra vez. Sí, José, así. Anda, José, así. Ay, José.
Machito and his orchestra. De los años que llevo aquí, que son 40 y tantos, y que mi público hispano, vamos a decir primero puertorriqueños, porque cuando yo llegué aquí eran los más, y ahora todas las colonias que también nos aceptan y me quieren mucho y nos siguen donde quiera que nosotros vamos a tocar.
Hey, what can I tell you, man? You know, this is Salsa en la Calle. Today's Salsa Show for the Salsero and you. And we're featuring a little bit of the retrospective side of Frank Grillo Machito and Mario Bauzá. Of course, I can't tell you the whole entire history of these two great giants of the music in a half hour's time. But I want you to get a concept, an idea of what the music was like. You know, if it wasn't for Mario Bauzá, I don't think the marriage of Latin, Cuban, African, Cuban, Antillano music and jazz would have ever been gotten together. Because Mario Bauzá introduced a legendary conguero by the name of Chano Pozo to Dizzy Gillespie. And together they formed, between the bebop and the Afro-Cuban, Afro-Cuban jazz. And for that reason, we'll always hold that dear to us about the legend Mario Bauzá, who has made a tremendous impact in this music and this genre and the arrangements that this gentleman has done over the years. A perfect example is this particular tune coming up now. Another jam session by the Mario Bauzá Orchestra is called Tanga. Por favor, no se vaya nadie. We'll be right back. without a doubt, without anything more further to say, I just want to tell you that you can see Salsa La Calle every Mondays in Brooklyn on Channel 35 and Channel 68 at 12:30 in the afternoon and 8:30 at night in Manhattan, alternate Saturdays. Un sábado sí, un sábado no, at 10 p.m. on Channel 57, and in the Bronx every Saturdays at 3:30 in the afternoon on Channel 69. This is Salsa La Calle, today's salsa show for the salsero and you. I'm your host, Willie Villegas. Long live Eddie Palmieri. Hasta la próxima. Ciao. We'll be right back.